क्लास 10 बायोलॉजी चैप्टर 2 पार्ट 4। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द सेल साइकिल एंड द डिफरेंट फेजेस लाइक एम फेज एंड रेस्टिंग फेज। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एम फेज इन ब्रीफ। एम फेज फर्दर डिवाइड इंटू टू मोर फेजेस that are karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyokinesis is the division of nucleus and cytokinesis is the division of cytoplasm. So let's see what I have written about the karyokinesis as well as cytokinesis and a brief study of karyokinesis. See here. What I have written, karyokinesis is the division or splitting of nucleus into two daughter nuclei. Karyokinesis or division of nucleus completed in four different phases, because M phase, as taught earlier, that further divide into two phases, karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyokinesis is the division of nucleus, that division completed in four different phases, and these are prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. So see, what are the characteristic remarkable changes or features that takes place in the prophase or the first phase of M phase or mitosis? So the first of all, in the prophase, centriole that regulate and initiate cell division start moving apart and reach opposite poles. Chromosomes become distinct. Chromosomes duplicated as paired chromatids. See the figure here. Centriole duplicated and reach towards opposite poles. Chromosomes becomes distinct. Sister chromatids attach to each other at a point. So this is the point called centromere, through which sister chromatid attached. Spindle fibers appears in between the centrioles, forming a chromatic spindle. And the most remarkable feature in the prophase by which we can identify this phase is the disappearance of nuclear membrane and nucleolus. So these two structures disappear during the first phase. Once more, chromosomes become distinct, centriole move apart, spindle fiber appears in between the centriole, and the nuclear membrane and nucleus disappear. This takes place in the prophase of the M phase. Now come to the second phase, that is metaphase. Here in the metaphase, chromosomes attached with spindle fiber at centromere. See the figure. These are the spindle fiber, and these spindle fiber attached with the centromere of the chromosomes. And the most remarkable features, alignment of chromosome in one plane, that is the equatorial plane of the cell. This is the most remarkable feature by which we can identify this phase. Clear all of you? Now come to the third phase, that is anaphase. Here in the anaphase, centromere attaching the two sister chromatid split. What we have seen in the metaphase, chromatids or sister chromosome attached at a point known as centromere. So in the next phase, that is in anaphase, this centromere is split so that the sister chromatid of the chromosome separate and start moving apart towards the opposite pole. So you see the figure here. The sister chromatids moves apart, that is towards the opposite poles due to the shortening of the spindle fiber. When the spindle fiber that used to attach the centromere of the chromosome start contracting, centromere split and thus chromatids move apart, that is towards the poles. And this is movement of chromatids towards opposite pole is the remarkable feature of anaphase. One more feature that takes place in the anaphase is appearance of cytoplasmic furrow in the cell membrane of a cell. So this cytoplasmic furrow appears in anaphase stage of the mitosis. Must learn it asked in the exam. Now come to the last phase of the mitosis, that is telophase. Two sets of daughter chromosome reach opposite poles. See, two sets of daughter chromosome reach opposite pole. A spindle fiber that appears in between the centriole disappear. Chromosome thin out in the form of chromatin fiber. Now, we have studied that in prophase, nuclear membrane and nucleus disappear. Now, here in the last phase, nuclear membrane and nucleus will reappear. These four stages mainly mean for the separation of equal number of chromosome into two different nucleus. When the karyokinesis completed, it is followed by cytokinesis. So what is cytokinesis? It is the division of cytoplasm into two daughter cell. Thus, a single parent cell on the completion of cytokinesis, it will produce two daughter cells. Clear? Now, we have studied about the anaphase or mitosis in general, but in some point, they are differ in animal as well as in plant. So, where does the difference lies in mitosis of plant and animal cell? Now, see where. In the animal cell, esters are formed when cell division occurs, but in plant cell, esters are not formed. In animal cell, cytokinesis is carried out by cytoplasmic furrow that appears in between the cytoplasm and deepens and to divide the cytoplasm into two halves. But in plant, a cell plate will appear in between the cytoplasm. This cell plate moves towards the periphery, thus divide the cell into two equal halves. Clear? So, in short, in animal cell, cytoplasmic furrow appear, but in plant cell, a cell plate appear in the middle that moves towards the periphery and thus divide the cytoplasm into two equal halves. In animal cell, mitosis occur for the growth, repair, etc. But in plant, it only occurs in the growing tips for the lengthening and insides for increased girth. Means in plant, mitosis occur in two different parts, that in the apices of the shoot and root for the lengthening of the plant, and on the lateral side for the increase in the girth, that is the diameter. But in animal, throughout the body cells, because in animal development or growth occur in all direction. Now come to the next point, that is the significance of mitosis or the benefit, the advantage of mitosis. So mitosis occur in body or somatic cells for the growth, repair, replacement and regeneration for the growth of the body. By adding more and more cells, one can gain height or thickness of the body. Repair. When we get some injury, that injured part is healed by the division of cells that it repaired the healed wound part. Replacement. Some of the body cells do not able to divide. That cells are replaced by new cells, and new cells are produced by the mitosis. And the last, regeneration. Development or the replacement of certain organs. And the regeneration skill is maximum in case of lizards. When a lizard lost his tail, a new tail appear after a certain while. That appearance of new tail is called regeneration. Now, we have studied about the significance of mitosis, but in some unicellular organism like bacteria, amoeba, mitosis is the mode of reproduction, because here in this type of organism, simply an organism divide equally into two halves. So we can say that mitosis is also a mode of reproduction, but only in certain organisms that are unicellular. Now, meiosis. Meiosis, in other words, other mode of cell division that takes place in the germ or reproductive cells of animals or plants. In meiosis, chromosome number reduced to half, that is N or 23 chromosome in the gamete, so that fertilizer restored chromosome number into normal. Means when meiosis occur, that meiosis reduce the chromosome number of a parent cell into half, thus produce gametes. Means gametes contain half number of chromosome, haploid or N number of chromosome. And when fertilization occurs, means one fusion of gamete takes place, that fertilizer restores the normal number of chromosome. That's why meiosis occur. Now, significance, reproduction. Meiosis takes place in germ cell to produce gamete, animal cell produce either sperm or ovum. In plant, it produces pollen grains, that is male gametes, and egg cell, that are the female gamete. Next, it provides mixing of genes that occur in two different ways. We, child, are somehow similar to both of the parents. Means certain characters like mother and certain characters like father. How this is possible? So this is possible by the intermixing of genes of both the parents, and this is possible by one mechanism known as crossing over. So what is crossing over? Both maternal and paternal chromosome exchange their segments genes between homologous pair of chromosome, and this method is called crossing over. So here, when one parental chromosome when paternal chromosome mix with the maternal chromosome, both the sister chromatids exchange their segment by forming one X-shaped structure, and this X-shaped structure is known as chiasma. And by forming chiasma, chromosome exchange their segments, thus a new type of character can be seen among the individuals. So we have studied about the mitosis, different phases, meiosis and their significance. Clear all of you? Okay, good day.